Hey guys, guess what today is?
Gracie Abrams album release.
Good riddance. It's 11:57 p.m., so we have 3 minutes until the album drop. I think it's going to be super introspective.
I think it's going to be sad, but I think some will be, like, sad and angry.
See, I think they're all going to be, like, slow, soft Gracie, but they may ramp up in, like, production and speed in the way that Where Do We Go Now does. That's how I feel. Oh my gosh. There's a really big spider on the outside of your car that I just saw. Oh my gosh, Macy, wait, you gotta see this thing.
I don't wanna see it.
Did you see him? Dylan, I'm gonna put my feet up. It's 11:59. Okay, wait, okay. She was begging people to listen to it in order.
Okay.
And either with headphones in or in a car. This is gonna be the last album that we're gonna get to listen to of Gracie's, like, before she's huge. Well,
we hear her in concert.
It's 12. Maybe I don't want this hat.
It's here, okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Okay.
You were there all the time. You're the worst of my crimes.
Favorite crime.
You fell hard. I thought good riddance.
Oh, there's the album.
I never was the best to you.
It was like two bridges, essentially. Yeah.
Also, it almost starts worse when it's like introspective and taking responsibility.
Yes, I agree.
Than a song that's like blaming someone else.
Yeah.
Like, it hurts more to relate to this kind of song.
Yeah, at first I thought it was going to be like a tolerated vibe, like Taylor Swift, like I never was the best. But then you start to realize she's like acknowledging like,
yeah,
I was not the best.
And I destroyed every silver lining you had in your head, all of your feelings, I played with them. Go ahead, we can just call it conditioning. We were too different.
Oh my gosh. But it's upbeat enough to where like I could drive to this and like sing it and like I'm not sad necessarily.
I'm sad.
I mean,
we are ready for the next one.
It's called I Know It Won't Work. And that I think makes me angry.
Gosh, this is like, this is, it's a lot of thinking going on.
Ooh.
I left you here, heard you keep the extra closet empty. In case this year I come back and stay throughout my 20s. What if I won't? How am I supposed to put that gently down the road? You will love me until I'm
this is like really relatable.
Wow.
Like she looked at me and went.
Thinking the call was tough, but you're better off. I'm being honest, so won't you stop holding out for me when I don't want your ghost right now? Your house is haunted.
The lyrics in that were, heard you kept your empty your extra closet empty in case this year I come back to stay throughout my 20s. You will love me until you resent me.
He's gonna love her hoping she comes back until one day he realizes she's not, and then he's gonna hate her.
This is what got me, the second verse. I'm thinking everything you wish I wasn't. The call was tough, but you're better off. I'm being honest, so won't you stop holding out for me when I don't want it?
That's crazy. That's some crazy
this lyricism.
Shit.
Oh my gosh.
Gracie, girl.
Girl, Gracie, Aaron.
Guys, you guys do this. You gotta get deep with it, but like you don't have to like call us out.
You don't have to.
I think I'm feeling degrees of this song in my personal life. I won't say to what extent how much I relate to them, but it was a relatable song. It's just as much as her slow stuff.
But it's fun. Yes,
it's
you
fun.
Said it so well.
I'll heal eventually, but faster if you're next to me. And that reminds me of how, like, a lot of times girls will mourn a relationship while they're still in it as, like, a coping mechanism. And then when they're finally broken up, it's their, like, opportunity to move on. Guys will break up on a whim and then regret it months later because they don't mourn during the relationship.
Yeah.
So that's what I get from this is, like, she's, like, healing the ending of their relationship, but it's going to be easier if she still has him next to her. That's how I interpreted that. I feel like no one's written a song about that, but that's such an experience that people have. Okay, The next one after that is Where Do We Go Now? Which we love and we've digested.
Okay, this one is, first off, explicit. Second off, I Should Hate You.
Oh.
I think this is either going to be, it's going to be insanely angry, I feel like. I just don't know if it's going to be sad angry or like upbeat angry. Frick me up. Oh no.
Right. breath when I tried to console you.
Okay.
Cause we didn't happen the way we were supposed to.
Gets angry.
Yeah, the way that it builds the whole song, and then she's the just like, I wasted my breath when I tried to console you.
Didn't I?
That didn't I.
It's the didn't I? Or earlier in her album when she goes, huh?
Yeah.
Is the it's subtle, it's small, it's the, but it's
pulled the knife out my back. It was right where you left it.
How it's all cause of you that my standards are broken.
Oh, bet you're doing all right and you don't even know.
The next one is so tragically, will you cry?
No!
And will we?
I don't
probably.
Know.
When you talk, you get shallow. Where I walk, oh, you don't follow.
I love the way that it sounds.
Damage lined up. Wreckage left behind us. Now you walk through me with my heart heavy. Breaking my rest. I could die early with your arms round me. Habits go slowly. Would it not kill to say goodbye? It's kind of funny when it goes from all to nothing. You have to laugh before you start to cry. Cause now I stop myself from holding on to something. Don't move me.
Giving tolerate it.
The sound reminds me of I see you every night in my sleep. Like that could be a mashup. It has the same like. Also, they're all very relatable. I don't know if that's like, I don't know if I should be worried about that. Should I be scared or
should I be concerned about that? I don't know.
Next one is Amelie,
which love, but processed. Love.
And then the and one then after difficult. That is difficult.
Love.
Next one.
Oh gosh.
This is what the drugs are for.
Ooh!
Oh. She's a little southern girl.
This is what the drugs are for.
Yeah, I haven't been
in a good way. But
I'm feeling so many conflicting emotions. Haven't seen you in a lifetime. What am I supposed to do when you used to be my lifeline? And she dropped that in the first 30 seconds of the song.
And she just said, y'all.
This next one's called Fault Line.
Oh, I love the guitar. You could go.
And the vocabulary, like, even just saying, does it shock you, reminds me of, like, an aftershock. When I'm down, I fall right back to you.
Point out is the cohesion in this album. Mm-hmm. The instruments are cohesive. She uses different track titles in the other songs.
Mm-hmm. Like, and the experience of it is very...
Yeah, like, it's very cohesive, I think, sonically and lyrically.
We have two more. The next one is called The Blue.
You live in Hollywood.
5 minutes.
You have to know.
Okay, girl.
You tell me on the phone you really want to meet my family. What are you doing to me now?
These melodies.
The little bro.
What
I love that.
Are you doing to me now?
I think this is her, like, realizing she might be moving on.
Expecting to receive a lover album.
Me either.
Song. I wasn't expecting to receive a love song.
That's cool because it could prelude to the next area, say this goes well. So this is very funny because a relationship that I think she's referring to in most of the other songs.
This is what I'm going through and now I'm here.
She was so right about the order.
Yeah, I'm
so
glad that we
important.
Did that.
Yeah. Best New Artist, 2024 Best New Artist, Gracie Abrams. I'm saying it here. 5 minutes and 50 seconds.
Oh, girl!
Look at me, I feel homesick.
Oh, girl, I'm about to graduate. I can't get a bed.
Oh, no! Oh, no, is she keeping the family?
And the light in the kitchen.
No, no, she's bringing the family to it.
No!
Through the walls of my bedroom.
as an overall, this album, fantastic.
Phenomenal, 10 out of 10.
It's the perfect merriment of, like, deep lyricism that is, like, introspective and heavy and
simple
at the same time.
There's such simple concepts in there that you're like, how has this never been said that way?
Yeah, the sound of it is so, it draws you in, makes you want to listen to it more.
A lot of them, the way that a lot of them were produced, like, a lot of the endings end on, like, repetition, and she just, like, lets you sit in it, which I love. That's my, you know, my favorite outro is All Too Well. And she repeats, and she lets you sit with it, and then you're just like, whoa. It's not an album that you have to know the songs to, like, differentiate them. This one, I listened through, and they were true to her and her sound, but
they sound cohesive, but they don't sound identical.
Yeah.
Thank you, Gracie. Thank you, Aaron Dessner.
I don't know who Gracie Abrams is. We hope that this put you on to one of the best artists of the decade. And if you do, thanks for listening with us. And this was so fun. Our brains, like, haven't fully processed. Like, every time we do one of these, I'm just like, I could sit here for another hour and just be like,
thinking.
Really. Yeah, so that happened.
Okay, bye. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching.